When you request a taxi or a rideshare in China these days, you are likely to be picked up by an electric vehicle or EV with a distinctive green license plate. When you get in one, you see all sorts of fancy gadgets. This one has a small AI robot on the dashboard that responds to your commands and sits to massage your back. And when you are running low on charge, you don't have to plug in and wait. Many stations can swap out batteries in a few minutes. Over the past decade, the number of EVs in China has grown to more than 20 million. And now, the carmaker selling the most EV globally is not Tesla, it's China's BYD. So, how did China make that happen in such a short time? Is China in the fast lane to dominate the global EV market? And most importantly, can the Chinese industry keep up the pace of rapid growth? The phrase 弯道超车, meaning to overtake on a ban, is commonly used in Chinese media to describe how the country's carmakers achieve dominance in the EV market. But while that sounds like sudden acceleration, China's EV boom was many years in the making. In the late 20th century, the country's auto industry was dominated by cars designed by foreign brands and manufactured through domestic joint ventures. By the early 2000s, it was clear that even after a decade of trying to catch up, developed countries still had a major lead over China when it came to internal combustion engines. Leaders in Beijing realized that they need a completely new approach to bypass the West's lead in legacy technology. In 2001, the government included the development of new energy vehicles in its five-year plan, the government's primary national planning document. Authorities gave 880 million yuan to universities and domestic car makers to support the development of EV technologies. Then, starting from 2009, the Chinese government set up 25 pilot cities to subsidize new energy vehicles. The following year, China also started subsidizing the production of private passenger electric vehicles, sometimes by as much as one-third of the cost. Its goal was for each city to have 1,000 electric vehicles in operation by the end of 2012. But the results of the program were disappointing. By 2013, the nation only had 27,000 new EVs on its roads. Most of them were buses, taxis, and other public vehicles. Only about 4,400 were private passenger cars. Even with subsidies, some cities only had 150 EVs running by the time the program ended. The dismal outcome was linked to a limited range of vehicle models and early technologies that were not able to satisfy real-world operating needs.
There is no breakthrough in the sense that it's very expensive at that time. It is around 2 to 3 times higher than the conventional vehicles. Because you see, battery is very expensive.
And the infrastructure needed to charge EVs was minimal. Still, authorities continued to double down on EV development, only with more refined and targeted strategies. Technological advancements allowed the government to narrow its focus on plug-in vehicles and ditch conventional hybrids. The central government's 12th five-year plan included an increased research budget for EVs and a vow to build and sell 500,000 plug-in EVs by 2015. And 2 million by 2020. The government also committed an additional 4 billion yuan in special funding to develop new vehicle models and key components such as batteries. Authorities also expanded the number of cities taking part in the new energy vehicle pilot program from 25 to 88. But China's EV strategies were not just about subsidies and favorable government policies. In 2015, several carmakers were found to have cheated the government out of some 1 billion yuan worth of subsidies. Authorities also began to realize that subsidies alone would not be enough. Officials decided that they needed a foreign catfish to push local carmakers to swim faster. In 2017, Shanghai's municipal government started providing numerous incentives for US EV maker Tesla to build a factory in the city. It was a win-win arrangement. The Shanghai factory is now Tesla's most productive plant. It also put the American company's Chinese competitors under pressure to catch up with Tesla in everything from affordability to technology. But now, Tesla is trying to keep up with its Chinese counterparts such as BYD and Li Auto. Beijing also managed to refine its subsidization program. EV subsidies were linked to vehicle performance, so manufacturers got more money for cars that could travel further with less electricity. Officials also kept raising the minimum driving range that all electric vehicles had to provide before carmakers could get subsidies. Meanwhile, the overall amount of subsidies offered kept shrinking year after year. The incentives are not limited to domestic carmakers. Foreign players like Tesla also benefit.
The Chinese subsidies get cleared relatively early. It kicks off relatively early. It adjusted into the latest trends to promote the technology evolution instead of just focus on the volume. And of course, some other benefits, including the waiver of the purchase tax, which is still levied at 10% on the ICE cars, and on the EV, that is zero.
There are also favorable licensing and road access policies for EVs in cities like Beijing and Shanghai. EVs can get a registration number right away, while traditional petrol cars must enter a lottery to get new plates. After the foundations were laid, production and sales of EVs took off in China. The rapid growth of EV production also helped turn around China's slowing auto sector. In 2023, its automobile exports surpassed Japan, making China the world's largest automobile exporter.
I think China realized that rather than continuing to put money in an old industry, maybe it was worth putting money in a new industry.
China's EV sales figures were below 1 million in 2017. By 2023, sales volume has surged to 9.5 million, with more than 70% of the vehicles made by Chinese carmakers. But selling more cars does not mean making more profit. China's BYD is currently the world's largest EV maker, but its profitability remains far behind rival Tesla because of the American giant's bigger profit margins. As of the third quarter of 2023, Tesla's per-car profit was $5,330. For BYD, the figure at the time was only $1,460. And the post-COVID economic slump in China has not made things easier for car makers. Multiple Chinese auto manufacturers have been reporting plunging delivery numbers. Then in January 2023, Tesla started slashing prices in the Chinese market. Other Chinese EV makers such as BYD soon followed suit, and it quickly turned into a price war.
The acceleration performance are different, and also the electronic auto driving autonomous is different. But the basic performance, that means the driving range. Right now, the commercial electric vehicle is more or less the same. It's around 400 kilometers per charge. Then it's sufficient, actually. It's sufficient. So right now, they compete one another based on price.
For the domestic one, it is always a competition. It is so easy to have so many entrepreneurs that are willing to explore the opportunities. So the competition is always fierce. That has prevented some car makers from profiting, for sure.
Only a handful of domestic market leaders like BYD and Li Auto have been profitable enough to further cut prices to squeeze out competitors. So where do Chinese carmakers look for more sales and profit? Overseas. And tapping foreign markets tops the to-do list of many Chinese carmakers as they fight for their survival. However, is it that easy to sell EVs to other countries?
Manufacturers are experiencing the need of going overseas because otherwise prices will continue to come down. To me, it's about realizing that they need to increase the production overseas. And they are already on this mindset, but I think this mindset will accelerate.
But there are already many hurdles on the way. Last year, the US passed a climate bill putting a focus on breaking the Chinese supply chain for electric vehicles. The European Union also opened a year-long subsidies probe into EVs made in China last October.
Actually, China's EV exports previously was mainly driven by the large demand in European markets. But since last year, we've seen a lot of Chinese brands trying to expand in emerging markets such as Southeast Asia and Middle East and South America.
In March 2024, Premier Li Qiang offered strong support for China to stay on course to an EV future. He told the political elite and lawmakers at the annual two sessions that Chinese firms now account for more than 60% of the world's electric vehicle output and sales, and he vowed to boost consumption of new energy vehicles. After more than 20 years of overtaking on the ban, China's carmakers are once again trying to steer their way through a critical time. It remains to be seen whether they will be able to keep up the momentum needed to keep thriving on the global stage.